What is up, guys? I'm going to do a snake lot lanyard with two colors, black and gecko. And it should look like this. For this project, you'll need paracord. You can use urban camo, gecko, safety orange. This is urban camo, this one is blue camo. Sorry, I think I traded the names. And you need a sharp knife. This is a Kershaw chill. I have a video on it if you want to check it out. You need a lighter to burn the ends of the paracord when you're done. You can use a Swiss Army knife. It has a knife, two knives by the way, and the scissors that you can get that perfect cut with it. If you want to be a bit more safe by using scissors instead of a knife, which I actually recommend. Now, let's do this project. Grab two pieces of paracord, where each one should have around 1 foot, which is 30 centimeters. You need to weld these two pieces together. And to do that, grab your scissors, choose a tip of each one, and trim that tip, like this. Burn them at the same time, like I'm doing here. Now that you have your two pieces joined together, let's do your lanyard. Now that we have our uni, it's really strong. We need to make the beginning of our lanyard, which is the loop. And to do the loop, and of course you want the lanyard to look good, so do it like this. You hide that union right there. Decide how long you want your lanyard loop to be. And my advice is to tie a string to it, because it helps to mark and it helps to make the first knot. Just to save you guys a little bit of time, I recommend you guys doing this. Just tie two regular knots like this. For this lanyard to look good, remember, hide that union. So the union is just a little bit below the loop. If the string that you use to mark it is bothering you, just cut it. Now, let's do this. Pay attention, because this is the most important part. Grab the left piece, throw it to the other side. Go around everything, like this. Now, grab this piece and feed it there. Tie that knot on the union, just on top of that, because that's what you're trying to hide. Like this. At this point, you can remove the string that was guiding you to where the first knot will be. Always grab the left one, go throw it to the right, go around everything, and feed it in the hole. Should have something like this. Now just tie it. Stack those knots, make sure they are aligned. Because if you're just a little bit off, your lanyard won't look as good. There you go, second. Let's do it again. Grab the left piece, go to the right, around everything, and feed it in that hole. Tie it. Stack those knots, work those knots, make it look good. Now, less time to teach you guys. Left piece goes to the right, around everything, leave a loop like this, and feed that through there. Got it? Just tie it again. Very easy, guys, and in the end you have a really good looking lanyard. I'll finish this up, guys, really fast, and show you guys the final result. What should you expect? Sometimes you need to twist the knots a little bit because they are off the alignment. Just twist them and squeeze them until you're happy with the result. Once you're happy with the length, just cut it. Save the rest of the paracord for the other days. They might be small, but you might find a project that will be useful. Even for this small piece, you can do a fishing lure with it. Now, that's it. Our snake lot lanyard, just twist it a little bit to align those knots. And that's it. Really love the color combination on this one. I think it came out really nice. Really like it. Hope you guys enjoyed this project. If you do, please give me a thumbs up down there below. And if you want to try this project later, add it to your favorites, so you won't miss or lose this video. Take care, guys. I really appreciate every single view. Thank you so much for all the support. Take care.